Hi, I'm Alex. Here's a riddle for you. What can you own but never hold? Let me show you. Welcome to cyberspace, home to a lot of the things that we use in our daily lives. Games, videos, and so much of our data. But also, here it is, crypto assets. You've probably heard of a few, maybe Bitcoin, Ether, or others. So what am I driving at here? After the global financial crisis, trust in banks was at an all-time low. Crypto assets were created as an alternative way to make payments, democratizing and decentralizing finance, basically taking power away from banks and putting it in the hands of the people. The idea was that they were going to fundamentally change the world of finance with their decentralized ledger technology, the blockchain. So, what's the catch? Without backing assets or a central authority, crypto assets seem to be really, really volatile. That's great if you want to gamble, not so great if you want to pay for something. Because how can you really pay for something with an asset that isn't a stable store of value? Enter the stablecoin. A crypto asset built on the blockchain, but usually with a centralized issuer. While the value of crypto assets like Bitcoin is determined by supply and demand, stablecoins aim to have value by being pegged to another asset in one of two ways. The first is by backing the stablecoin with another asset, like the dollar, the euro, or even a commodity like gold, in theory, keeping a one-to-one parity. But wait a minute, doesn't this go against the founding premise of crypto? Maybe, but it also allows users to stay in the crypto universe without all the volatility. The second way stablecoins try to maintain value is through an algorithm, a formula that automatically raises and lowers the total number of a given asset in response to supply and demand to keep the price at or near par. One danger with stablecoins is market shocks. If prices begin to fall too quickly, or users lose faith in the ability of the stablecoin to keep its desired pace, everyone could try to sell their stablecoins all at once, dropping their value almost overnight. There are a few famous examples of stablecoins that have crashed over the years. Some people lost all their savings after relying on something they believed had a fixed value. So, is this the end of the stablecoin story? We can't really be sure. Some still see the promise. They think that stablecoins have the potential to increase access to financial services and become a viable payment method. But for that to happen, there needs to be regulation to prevent fraud and crashes and to protect users from abuse. Before imposing regulation, authorities will look at how people are actually using stablecoins, whether it's for payments or something else. Some authorities are looking to regulate the bigger stablecoins the way they do banks and other traditional financial institutions. Now, here's the real riddle. If these stablecoins are regulated like banks, don't they end up becoming the banks that crypto assets were meant to replace?